Good morning again, everyone. Welcome back. Home health care we're talking about this morning. You know, it can be a huge convenience for people looking to stay in their homes, but choosing a provider, that can be a little overwhelming. This morning, we're getting an idea of the resources that can help people make that important decision. Joining us is Lisa Clark with the McLean Health Center. Lisa, thank you so much for coming in this morning.
Thanks for having me.
First of all, tell us, when might someone be looking for this kind of health care?
Anytime a person finds themselves being ill, they might have had a hospital visit or gone to the doctors and are struggling to get in and out of their home.
And I think a lot of people might think this is associated with more of an elderly patient, but not necessarily.
Not necessarily. We have seen clients who are younger who just have found themselves to be in a bad spot and they need a little bit of care at home.
Okay, so then the next question is, how do you choose an agency or some sort of provider to help you out with this? How do you know what makes a good agency?
Well, Medicare does a wonderful job at comparing us. And if you go to the website, medicare.gov, you can go right into Home Health Compare and you can find all the statistics to see what makes an agency good. For example, at McLean, we're measuring ourselves all the time, and one of the statistics is rehospitalization rate, because we don't want to have any of our clients go back in and out of the hospital.
Sure.
Seeing a low percentage of that is great, and we were just recognized to be one of the lowest in the nation.
That is wonderful.
Yeah,
that is really proud. Good to hear.
Mm-hmm.
You know, this just strikes me as something that sounds, maybe it's changed, but perhaps in the past, I've just always thought of it as something that's so expensive that most people would be excluded from being able to afford.
Right. Medicare covers 100% of a person's home health care stay.
Wow.
A lot of insurances do as well, but recognize the nurse only goes a couple times a week and the therapist may go just a few times a week to make sure you're getting what you need to recover.
And so explain to people that don't really necessarily know what we're talking about. So it means you basically can heal and stay and convalesce in your own home.
Yes.
And everybody comes to you.
Yes, they do. Yes.
That's what doctors, therapists?
The doctors don't.
Okay.
We have a few doctors who will visit the homes, mm-hmm. but most often it's just the nurse, the therapist, or a home health aide who helps with personal care like a bath or a shower, or doing some chores around the house as well.
Mm-hmm. You know, is there some place that people can go to learn more about the different agencies available? I know one thing that when it comes to medical issues, people always want to check records. Is there some place to check an agency's record?
The state has a site as well that will tell you how they did in their survey process, but the best resource truly is Medicare.gov.
Mm-hmm. So that's worth checking out. We'll put that website up on our website for you later. You know, could this help perhaps the process of, I mean, going through such a traumatic injury or whether it's just care that you need that is sort of a chronic condition, whatever it is, I've got to think that the healing or perhaps certainly the mental health of the whole process would be a lot better if you can stay in your home and have people come to you.
It is, and it also allows the therapist and the nurse to set up your home so you can be really successful in getting around and getting about. And we're finding the trend today more and more. People just want to stay at home. They
Absolutely.
Don't really want to go into a healthcare setting.
Well, interesting. And this is a way of doing that. So, Lisa, thank you so much for coming. We want to put some information on the screen. If anyone watching has a question for Lisa that we didn't answer, you can reach her at the number that we're putting up there on your screen. Also, send her an email or visit the website as well. That's all okay, right, Lisa?
Absolutely. Okay. Please call me. There's so many questions that come up, and we'd love to help.
Wonderful. We're coming right back. Thanks again.
You're welcome. Thank you.